Good morning, students. How are you? Hope all are okay. Children, nowadays the whole world is facing the pandemic, that is COVID-19, which is also called as a coronavirus. It affects all of us and also affects our educational system. As we know that the whole country, everyone, it may be a middle class, it may be a rich person or workers, everyone is facing various problems, and our educational system is also facing the same problem. Because of that, what happened, we all are not able to attend the school as previously we are doing. We are coming to school, we are coming together, we are doing all the things with one another. Daily assembly is going on. In the class, many students were sitting together, teachers are coming, they are teaching. There is an interaction between the teacher and the students. But nowadays, this all things were not possible. Because of that, what is happening? There is no direct communication in between us. And all these things are because of the pandemic, that is COVID. Okay, in this what will happen, the coronavirus, it is a type of virus which may be spread by the direct contact with one another. This is a type of a communicable disease which may spread by direct contact, by touching one another, by greeting one another, by taking one other's things, by touching anything. So, our government and the officers, they have decided to continue the study as we have done last year also by the online teaching. Last year also we have studied the whole year through the online teaching. You have given the exam also online. This year also we are doing the same thing. But the main thing is that this year the chemistry which you are studying is different from the last year. Last year you have studied chemistry in standard 6, that is a little bit different, and in this year 7th standard the chemistry which you are going to study, it is different. Okay, there is lot of changes among both the chemistries. The basic things were same, but the content, but the facts, the things which is present in this, it is little more enhanced. Now this year also we will study the our subject, that is chemistry, through the online classes only. I'm Samita Shukla, your chemistry teacher. I'm welcoming you in the online classes. Today we are going to start our the first subject, that is chemistry. In this lecture I'm introducing you about the syllabus and everything, then we will move towards the first chapter, that is matter and its composition. Before moving to the main content of the lesson, I want to explain you about the content, about the index of the book. So let us move towards that. The first chapter is matter. So our the first lesson is matter and its composition. Okay, in this lesson we are going to study about the matter, about our universe, their various physical states. So let us see what is given in this chapter. See children, our universe is made up of matter and energy. What is that? Universe is made up of matter and by energy. Okay, as we know that we are surrounded by matter, we are ourselves made up of matter. The air we breathe, the water we drink, the clothes we wear, the food we eat, the land over which we walk, the things which we are using to play, all and each and everything is made up of matter. In fact, all the things which are present in our surrounding, they are constituted of matter. So before moving towards the another point, Let me explain you about the matter. What do you mean by matter? Matter is nothing but anything that occupies space, has weight and can be perceived by our sense is called as matter. So definition will be anything that occupies space, has weight and can be perceived by our senses is called as matter. Now, it can be perceived by our sense means sense organ. Like if we touch anything, if we feel anything, if we smell anything, if we hear anything, everything is nothing but considered as a matter. Matter can be ranges from something small as needle or to something as big as an aeroplane or a mountain. So everything which we see is called as matter. It may be small, it may be big. Okay, anything is there which is considered as a matter. In fact, the thing which we can't see, air, it is also considered as a matter. Why? Because it having a mass and it also occupies space, so it is considered as a matter. Other than that, light, it is not considered as a matter because it doesn't have any weight and it doesn't carry any of the space. To show this air occupies space, we can perform an experiment. Now do one thing, take two balloons, okay, before inflating them, weight them. Suppose the first and the second balloon, before inflation, they having weight 5 grams. Now keep the first balloon as it is and the second balloon, you start blowing it. When you blow it, tied it and now weight the second balloon. Let the first balloon as it is and blow the first balloon, keep it as it is. Suppose this is of 5 grams. The second also is of 5 gram only before blowing. After blowing, the size of the balloon, it will get changed. Okay, and when you weight this after blowing, its weight will become suppose 10 grams. Okay, so the balloon, this balloon is filled with the air which is present in it, it having the weight of 5 grams. That's why air considered as a matter. Because when the balloon which is blown with air, the air which is filled in it, it increased the size of the balloon. And because of the air which is present in it, it having some mass and it shows all the properties of matter. That's why air is considered as a matter. Okay. After that, the next point is properties of matter. Properties of matter. Matter having the three properties. It occupies space, it has mass and it can be perceived by our sense organ. So if anything which having all these properties, it is considered as a matter. If it occupies some space, it has some mass and it can be perceived by our sense organ, it is considered as a matter. Now after that, on page number 12, skillful is given, that we will do later. Okay, so today we will stop here only. In the next lecture, we will move towards the next point of the chapter, that is state of matter. Till then children, stay home, stay safe. Good day.